So Pennsylvania's primary date may be on the move. And the Commonwealth's avian flu outbreak is over. Welcome to The Morning Agenda, WITF's daily news podcast, where the only agenda is you. A good morning to you. It is Thursday, August 31st, the final day of the month, and this is being recorded at 9:18 a.m. I'm your host, Tim Lambert, as we take this daily trip around the region's top stories. So let's get to it. Poor families of color appear to be suffering disproportionately under the state's child abuse registry. My colleague Gabriela Martinez has more on a joint study by Temple University and the University of Pennsylvania.
From 2015 through 2021, Black Pennsylvanians made up 22% of child abuse investigations. That's nearly twice their share of the general population. When a caseworker conducts even a brief investigation and finds what they feel is substantial evidence of abuse or neglect, they can place those parents on the state's child abuse registry. And that can happen even before that person has had a chance to defend themselves in court. Jamie Gullen, a managing attorney at Community Legal Services in Philadelphia, says a person can stay on that registry for life, even if they are later found to be innocent.
So parents get their kids back or never had their kids removed, but they're still on the registry. And what that does is it means they can't work in a whole wide range of jobs to better support their kids.
Now, at the same time, the researchers found most people who appeal their placement on the registry before a judge are successful. The state Senate has returned to work at the Capitol for several voting sessions. My colleague Ben Wasserstein reports the upper chamber is bringing the budget closer to completion.
In order for the budget to be fully implemented, additional legislation known as code bills are needed. Upon the Senate's return, two of these bills were voted on and passed the chamber. Republican Majority Leader Joe Pittman of Indiana County noted divisions within the legislature, but recognized the importance of passing the additional legislation.
We have had, at moments, dysfunctional government. But what we have here today is legislation that puts forward the basic needs of implementing a budget.
So one of the code bills earmarked funds for services such as reimbursements for school breakfasts. The second was initially set to fund services such as cancer research, but was amended to also include a $100 million school voucher program that's favored by Senate Republicans. The legislation now heads to the House, which returns to session on September 26th. State lawmakers are also advancing legislation to hold the Commonwealth's 2024 presidential primary earlier. But it would not give voters much more say in deciding presidential nominees. A Senate committee has passed a bill to change Pennsylvania's primary from April 23rd to March 19th. But that still leaves highly populous states ahead of the Commonwealth, and lawmakers say a final bill could move it later. Many lawmakers want an early primary date, but not so early that it pushes the primary campaign into the winter holiday season. This year, some were motivated to support a change because April 23rd is the first day of Passover, a Jewish holiday. Well, signs highlighting suicide awareness may be required in state parks and forests with the hope the effort can save lives. State Representative Kristen Marcel and Kathleen Tomlinson, both of Bucks County, are working on a measure to address the issue. Marcel says she was moved to take action following the death by suicide of a young woman at Tyler State Park in her district. She says putting up signs is an easy way to let people know that help is available.
This would really be an easy way for us to advertise and post that information about the crisis line and suicide awareness in all state parks and forests throughout the Commonwealth.
According to 2021 data from the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention, the suicide rate in Pennsylvania is 13.9 per 100,000. That's almost on par with the national average and close to twice as high as neighboring New York and New Jersey. And I want to note, too, if you are considering suicide or just need to talk to someone, please dial 988 to reach someone 24/7. And Philadelphia Phillies slugger Bryce Harper has hit his 300th career home run, becoming the 158th player in Major League history to reach that mark. He hit the milestone homer against the Los Angeles Angels' Matt Moore in the eighth inning. It was his 15th of the season. He has now homered in three straight games for the second time this month and has 10 home runs in the month of August. The Phillies, however, lost that game 10-8. If you hadn't heard, The Morning Agenda is now available on YouTube. You can subscribe to the WITF channel. And remember, you can subscribe to the podcast wherever you find your favorite podcast. Subscribe to it, give it a rating, and let us know what you think in a review. That will be very helpful in spreading the word about The Morning Agenda. And of course, you can always do that yourself on social media. Let your friends know about it too. We always appreciate your help in spreading the word. So this morning I went through close to a dozen news sites, like I do each and every day, from across central Pennsylvania, looking for just a few stories to put on your radar because they cover issues that could impact you or your community, or just might be of interest because it might be something that is being discussed in your community as well. So here's what you need to know. After more than a year of reported cases of avian influenza, Pennsylvania's outbreak is over. Governor Josh Shapiro and the State Department of Agriculture say the designation by the World Animal Health Organization allows the state's poultry industry to return to normal international trade. Now, since April 2022, Pennsylvania experienced an outbreak that affected 31 commercial flocks and 36 backyard flocks at a loss of more than 4.6 million domestic birds. Our sister newsroom, LNP Lancaster Online, reports the last confirmed infection of the current strain in the state was March 17th in Lancaster County. Restrictions on farms that had been impacted were lifted in early August. The Commonwealth remains under a general quarantine as a measure to protect the poultry industry from the spread of the virus. And a mid-state county is distributing its share of funds from nationwide settlements with opioid manufacturers and distributors. The York Dispatch reports 11 organizations in York County will receive more than $2 million. So the money comes from $21 million the county will receive over the next 18 years from settlements with Johnson & Johnson and three major drug distributors. The county will seek funding applications as it spends those funds, largely on programs related to responding to and warding off the effects of the opioid epidemic. The county first sued 25 drug manufacturers and distributors in 2017 for misleading the public and downplaying the risks of using opioids, becoming the fourth county in the state at the time to do so. And I'll tell you, I'm very, very excited today. People in the building are actually laughing at me a bit because we have our merch. The Morning Agenda trucker hat has arrived thanks to Hanover's League Legacy, and they look fantastic. I'm not ashamed to say, I think they're pretty sharp. If you'd like to see a photo of them, you can check them out on my Instagram page. It's Tim_Lambert_WITF. I also posted some pictures on my Facebook page as well. And I want to make sure you, the loyal listener of The Morning Agenda each and every day, gets first crack at these hats if you'd like one. So stay tuned. We're working out the details on how we'll be able to offer them up for you. And a big thanks to our super listener, Greg Young, who gave me his song of the day today, Down by the Water by the Decemberists. That's a fantastic pick. So how about you? What is the one song that is in your head today? Let me know about it on Twitter. I'm at TLambert895, and I'll give you a shout out in future episodes of The Morning Agenda. And this is the last day to check out our August Spotify playlist. It's called The Morning Agenda Song of the Day, August 2023. I know. I've got to get more creative in naming things. My pick today, going back for MC Hammer. Turn this mother out. Just get by the parachute pants and think about the song. And that is going to do it for The Morning Agenda today. It's a daily news podcast from WITF where the only agenda is you. I'm your host, Tim Lambert. Thank you so much for listening today. Your company is always appreciated and never taken for granted. Be well. Enjoy the rest of the day, and we'll talk again tomorrow.